Welcome to Georgia Wild. I'm Trina Morris, and it's the time of year to talk about bats. Bats might seem spooky, but they're not truly scary. Actually, they're necessary. Georgia has 16 different species of bats, and our bats feed exclusively on insects. In fact, one bat can eat almost its entire body weight in insects in a night. That can be over 1,000 mosquito-sized insects each hour. It's estimated that bats may save farmers up to $23 billion in pest control each year. Imagine what would happen to our food if we lost bats. But sometimes bats can cause problems. What would you do if you had bats in your belfry? When people find bats in their house, it's usually a small number, and most landowners can humanely and safely evict them themselves. But if you have large numbers, you may want to hire a professional. Visit our website for more information on how to do that. So what do you do for bats you evict? Well, you can put up a bat house. This is a single chamber starter bat house. It's pretty easy to build. You can also put up one with three or four chambers that's a little larger. Put one up and bats just might move in during the summer. If you want to build or buy a house, just be sure the design is certified by Bat Conservation International. Also, put it at least 15 to 20 feet above the ground and make sure it's in a nice sunny location. Visit our website for more information and plans for bat houses. Many people ask me why they don't see as many bats as they used to. Bats have faced a variety of threats, including habitat loss, exposure to pesticides, reduced water quality, and disturbance to cave habitats. However, the most recent and significant threat to bats is white nose syndrome. This disease is caused by a fungus that's not native to North America. Since its arrival in New York in 2006, it has killed millions of bats and spread across the continent. In our state, we have lost 92% of the bats in the caves that DNR surveys every winter. Learn more about white nose syndrome and what we're doing to help on our website. Still think bats are big and scary? Let's take a look. First, remember to never handle a bat. Though it's likely less than half of 1% of bats have rabies, they are likely to bite you if you pick them up. I'm going to show you a couple of common Georgia species that you're likely to find in your bat house. This is a Mexican or Brazilian free-tailed bat. It is mostly found in man-made structures. It's small, it has very little teeth, and it's the only bat we have that has a little mouse-like tail that extends beyond its tail membrane. And here's probably the most common bat that people find behind their shutters or in attic vents in Georgia. This is a big brown bat. You can see she's definitely bigger than the free-tailed bat, but really not that big. Big brown bats have big teeth because they eat a lot of beetles. They are great flyers, like all of our bats, and they are a lot more like us than mice or rats. Most of our bats have just one pup a year and can live over 30 years in the wild. Bats' wings are basically just a modified arm, and if you look, you can see that they have a thumb and four fingers, and they just have a lot of skin and long finger bones that allow them to fly. That's cool if you ask me. Well, I hope you've learned some new things about bats and maybe even gained an appreciation for them. Find out more at georgiawildlife.com. Bye for now, and thank you for helping to keep Georgia wild.